right, so let's get started. Welcome everyone to the regular business meeting of Reading City Council here on Monday, January 25th, 2021. We're going to open this evening's meeting with the invocation by Nancy Leonard from Transformative Solutions Network. And then we will stand for the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag. Welcome, Nancy.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone. And good evening, council members, distinguished guests, and loyal residents of Reading, Pennsylvania. The Lord has called us together in his name during this Reading City Council meeting to give him all glory and honor. Father is faithful, and he has proven himself over and over, so we shall never doubt in his coming, in his love, in his son Jesus, in his protection, and in his guidance. Father, we offer up to you your word in prayer. I'm reading from Colossians chapter 3, verses 23 and 24. Whatever you do, work heartily as for the Lord and not for men, knowing that from the Lord you will receive the inheritance as your reward. You are serving the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Lord, you have called us each by name. You have positioned us to be a witness for you and of you. You are great and mighty, Lord, and nothing or no one is before you. You are God Almighty and King you shall always be. Let the heavens cry out for your coming and let the earth receive its King. May the peace of our Lord rule and reign forever in the hearts of this council and all who attend. Council members, may wisdom forever rule in you as you continue to lead Reading, Pennsylvania, as a beautiful city on the hill. Amen.
Okay, thank you, Nancy. Everyone, please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America
and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Mr. Peter Freitas? Ms. Goodman-Henderschitz?
Here.
Mr. Marmorou? Mr. Marmorou?
Here.
Ms. Reed?
Here.
Ms. Sahelnik?
Marmorou? Here.
Ms. Ventura?
Here.
I'm here.
Mr. Waltman, President.
Here.
Five here. Present, two absent.
And just to make note, Lucine and Johanny just had some personal matters this evening. They've been excused from the meetings, and we look forward to having them back hopefully next week. Moving on the agenda, the next item is public comment. We have just one written comment. I believe Donna's going to read that for us onto the record this evening. Go ahead, Donna.
And do you want the formal postscript or?
Since you're reading the written comment, we're okay.
Okay, this is from Ernest Herbline Schlegel, who is a resident of District 5 and also serves as chair of the Reading Redevelopment Authority. And these are the words of Mr. Schlegel. Good evening, Council. I'm writing to encourage Council to support Bill 9-2021. As you are aware, Council passed Resolution 163-2020, which included payment for professional services, which included executive director and staffing services. We, the board, are pleased with the exceptional services we are getting from our staff, and more importantly, those services are more targeted to the needs of the Redevelopment Authority, allowing it to eliminate wasteful spending. With power of eminent domain, robust holdings of property, and a staff with deep technical expertise, the authority is likely to remain a vital tool in the city's fight to redevelop blighted properties, blighted neighborhoods, and to fuel economic growth. We have worked tirelessly to make the authority relevant again. We are well on our way to stabilizing ourselves financially. We need to stabilize our morale and pay them for the work they have done. And we need to stabilize our employee structure, for which with the operating agreement we have achieved. We've come a long way in a relatively short period of time. We're moving in the right direction, recognizing some of the administrative problems the authority had and are correcting them. We've put new financial policies in place in 2020 and we'll be working on property tracking systems in 2021, an overhauled property disposition policy, and the opening of the front door, a unified entry point for developers, nonprofits, and average residents interested in buying city-owned land. The authority had an operating deficit for a number of years. That they made that up by working with what we've called working capital, and that's masked how big the problem is. The board recognizes that, our administration recognizes that, and the authority auditor affirmed that. I don't think the authority can or should continue to spend down those funds to maintain our administrative costs. In 2021, we aim to correct that by creating a sustainable revenue stream through public-private partnerships and also the administration of the city's home funds by development of properties. Again, thank you for your continued efforts in economic development, and I encourage you to support Bill 9-2021. This again from Ernest Herbine Schlegel, Chairman of the Reading Redevelopment Authority.
All right, thank you, Donna. We're going to move on to the approval of our agenda in minutes. Includes the minutes of our January 4th special meeting and January 11th regular meeting, and also approving the summations of discussion from the January 11th and January 19th Committee of the Whole meetings, as well as the January 19th Nominations and Appointments Committee meeting. As part of the approval for the consent of the agenda is the consent agenda items. We're going to read through these quickly. The first item is an award of contract to Herneisen Electric, the low bidder for the replacement of the McKnight and Spring Street Firehouse original electric gear and the electric backup generator at a total cost of $85,445. The next item under the consent agenda is a resolution authorizing the sewage planning module for the 810 Windsor Street Apartments. The next item under the consent agenda is authorizing the hiring of 12 firefighters and paramedics for the 2021 Fire Academy class. They are Justin Benner, Brett Buskirk, Michael Grilly, Corrigan Herbert, Charles LaGrassa, Alexander Marska, Sean McCormick, Brett Noel Emick, Timothy Perron, Lucas Richardson, Anthony Trento, and Adam Webster. I wish I would have practiced them earlier. Jesus, there. And the next item is awarded contract for the purchase of 38 sets of firefighter personnel protective equipment for the Academy class and the replacement of the equipment at the end of its useful life from the Reading Fire Equipment Inc. in Reading, PA, a CoStars vendor at the price of $122,030.54. The next resolution under the consent agenda is extending the contract of Interim Public Works Director Charlie Jones for an additional 6 months retroactive to January 1st of this year. And the final item under the consent agenda items is an award of contract for the award of the Downtown Plus Strategic Master Plan Project to StanTech in Philadelphia at the cost of $272,725 to facilitate the direction, type, location, and scale of new development and associated downtown improvements for the next 10 years with a focus on achievable outcomes over the next 5 years. That's the final item under the consent agenda. Is there any objection to the approval of the minutes and the agenda and the consent agenda items at this time? If not, they stand as approved. We're going to move on to the administrative report. We have a couple of young men here this evening. I forgot to mention the mayor and managing director both had some family matters to tend to this evening, but to help represent them here this evening, we do have Nate Rivera and Mr. Frank Dombowski.
Thank you, Council President. Good evening, members of council and the viewing public. I will be providing the highlights of the administrative report that was submitted to council today. Just some brief highlights. Mayor Eddie Moran virtually met with community stakeholders on Wednesday, January 13th, to discuss the city stepping in to provide services to the downtown area previously provided by the former Downtown Improvement District. We will also be having a follow-up meeting early in February, and members of council will be updated on the details and time and place of that meeting. The Community Development Department continues to assist developers with questions and processes due to increased interest in city development. With finance, as we heard a very detailed presentation from our finance director, Jamar Kelly, the finance department's information technology division is diligently working on upgrades to our internal systems and installation of software throughout various city departments. It's probably one of our most comprehensive approaches and plans for integrating our software so it can speak to each other and other organizations. As far as Human Relations Commission, as of January 19th, the Human Relations Commission has reported 761 total applications for rent and utility assistance that were received. It's noted here that in the last month, that's an additional 51 applications since last reported to council. Actually, that would be 2 weeks ago. So 51 applications in the last 2 weeks, with a total of most of them for rental assistance and then some were for utility assistance. In regards to the library, kind of like a fun fact here, but duly noted that the Reading Public Library calculated that patrons saved $1.4 million in 2020 by borrowing materials than buying the materials. So there's a great benefit to our residents. The Reading Public Library main branch ceiling repair project continues, and in the report that was provided to council and is available to the public on the website, you'll see pictures of that project progressing. So that's pretty exciting. And last and finally, our public works departments began their winter shift implementation, which started on January 4th. And it basically means there's a first and third shift for the winter season. So we have people pretty much all around the clock. And for those who are participating or interested in yard waste collection, because of the time of the year, January, February, March, we only do that on Wednesdays. If you would like yard waste collection picked up or if you have any questions, please call the Citizen Service Center to arrange that at 1-877-727-3234. And lastly, the Public Works street sweepers are now servicing the downtown regularly, and the trash receptacles are being emptied on a daily basis by our third shift crew. So those are the highlights of the administrative report submitted by both the mayor and the managing director. I don't know if there's any opening questions.
Okay, thank you, Frank, for the report. Council members, does anybody have any questions or comments at this time? Okay, if not, again. I'm sorry, we're gonna move on now. Thank you again, Frank, for the report. We're gonna move on to the report from our city auditor, and we're gonna welcome the Honorable Maria Rodriguez. Good evening.
Good evening, thank you, Council President. Good evening, everyone. My report tonight, the first item is on the local service tax, which include also the local service tax prior as of December 31st, 2020. For the fiscal year 2020, the city budgeted $1.2 million for the local service tax total. And as of December 31st, 2020, the city had collected $854,442.56, or 70% of total amount budgeted. For the fiscal year 2019, the city budgeted $1.2 million for this line item and $1,189,060.87. Or 99% was collected as of December 31st, 2019. Although this report is showing that revenue collected is as of December 31st, 2020, which might take into consideration that any revenue received for this line item during the first sixty days of the current year will be accrual to 2020. So we had a window there to bring more revenue on this line item for 2020. The second line item, the business privilege tax and business privilege tax revenue tax prior year. All days as of December 31st, 2020. For the fiscal year 2020, the city budgeted $2,090,900 for business privilege tax total. And as of December 31st, 2020, the city had collected $1,850,977.24, or 89% of total amount budgeted. For the same period of 2019, the city collected $1,833,123.12 of total amount budgeted, although the same percentage has been collected.
Did we lose Maria? Oh, Maria's muted. Maria, you're muted all of a sudden.
So you didn't hear anything?
Just the last 30 seconds.
Okay. For the same period, 2019, the city collected $1,833,023.12 of total amount budgeted for this line item. And although the same percentage has been collected for both years, $30,900 more was budgeted for the fiscal year 2020. So, by saying that, the revenue collected this year has been very good. On January 14, 2021, an email was received from Mr. John Boyle from the Department of the Auditor General, stating the completion of the audit for the Reading Pension Funds for the period of January 1st, 2018 to December 31st, 2019. The city has three pension funds, which are the police, fire, and the ONE. During this audit, the city auditor office, along with the pension administrator and the city controller assistant, Mr. John Boyle, with this audit. I would like to thank you, Mr. Michael Oppenheimer, for taking the initiative to revise the MMO calculation for the fiscal year 2018 and 2019 before the Auditor General came on board. Due to those minor mistakes that he found, he was able to fix those ones. The audit for the fire and police, it was only about one finding, so another finding was deleted from the audit, and the ONE has two findings. Also, I want to thank you, Mrs. Liliana Castillo, our city pension administrator, for assisting the external auditor during the audit process. This is my report for tonight, and I'm open for questions. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Maria. Are there any comments or questions for the city auditor at this time? Okay, if not, again, thank you, Maria, for the report. We're gonna move on. You're welcome. We're gonna move on to the next item on our agenda. And that is, we had someone originally scheduled this evening, the charter board, but we've had to reschedule that. So we do not have any reports from department directors, boards, or authorities this evening. We're gonna move on to ordinances for final passage. Excuse me, the first ordinance, is Bill number 102-2020, amending the city code section 576-416, increasing and reducing parking fines and penalties and retaining the current parking meter rate as attached. This was introduced at the December 14th regular meeting, tabled at the December 28th regular meeting, amended and tabled at the January 4th special meeting, and reintroduced at the January 11th regular meeting. Is there a motion, please?
So moved.
Second.
All right, are there any comments? We did discuss these at length, so it wouldn't surprise me if there's no comments. If there are no comments, Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Goodman-Hinderschitz, seconded by Councilor Marmorou, to enact Bill number 102-2020, which amends the parking code chapter 576-416, which increases and reduces fines and penalties. Ms. Goodman-Hinderschitz?
Yes.
Mr. Marmorou?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Ms. Ventura? Ms. Ventura?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
5 yeas, no nays.
Our next ordinance is Bill Number 3-2021, amending the City of Reading Code Section 212-144, vehicles and traffic to reduce the booting fee and to notify the daily parking permit fees and parking meter fee. This was introduced at the January 11th regular meeting. I believe I said modify the daily parking fee and parking meter fee. Is there a motion, please?
So moved.
Not yet.
Second.
Been properly moved and seconded. Are there any comments? Again, we've discussed these first few ordinances at length. If not, Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Marmaru, seconded by Councilor Ventura, to enact Bill Number 3-2021, which reduces the boot fee and modifies the daily parking permit fees. Mr. Marmaru?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Ms. Ventura?
Yes.
Ms. Goodman-Henderschitz?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
5 yeas, no nays.
Next ordinance is Bill Number 4-2021, amending the City of Reading Code Section 576-502, parking zones established, traffic control maps as attached. This was introduced at the January 11th regular meeting. Is there a motion, please?
So moved.
It's been properly moved and seconded. Are there any
move to amend?
There's a motion to amend. Is there a second?
Second.
Okay.
I have to tell you what the amendment is, though.
You do, yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, help. We will remove from this the north side in the 800 block of Washington, the north side of the 800 block of Washington between Cedar Street and North 8th Street. And they will retain the 15-minute zone. And also that same 15-minute zone will move to retain that on the east side of North 8th Street from Washington to Court, and that is adjacent to the Reading School District building. And those particular slots will not meet, according to this amendment, they are not to be metered and retain a 15-minute business qualification for parking there.
Okay, now we can second that amendment. I'm sorry, go ahead.
Second.
All right, so any comments on the amendment by anybody? If not, Linda, can we have a roll call on the amendment?
Motion was made by Councilor Reed, seconded by Councilor Goodman-Henderschitz to amend Bill Number 4-2021 by retaining the visitor parking spaces on the north side of Washington Street from Cedar to North 8th and the east side of North 8th Street from Court to Washington. Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Ms. Ventura?
Yes.
Ms. Goodman-Henderschitz?
Yes.
Mr. Marmaru?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
5 yeas, no nays.
Our next ordinance is Bill Number 5-2021, amending City Code Chapter 5.
We have to adopt the Bill Number 4 as amended.
I'm sorry, that was the amendment. I'm sorry. Yep, go ahead, Lynn. Any other comments now that it's formally amended? If not, Linda, can we have a roll call? I'm sorry, I forget that was the amendment.
Motion was made by Councilor Reed, seconded by Councilor Goodman-Henderschitz to enact Bill Number 4-2021 as amended. Ms. Ventura?
Yes.
Ms. Goodman-Henderschitz?
Yes.
Mr. Marmaru?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
5 yeas, no nays.
Now, the next ordinance is Bill Number 5-2021, amending the City Code Chapter 576, stopping and parking, Section 413, and regarding the authority of the police chief to void parking tickets, and Section 514, requiring the police department and parking authority to provide notification regarding temporary changes to any parking rules or regulations. This was introduced at the January 11th regular meeting. Is there a motion, please?
Move to table.
Second.
Okay, it's a table motion. There's no discussion. Linda, can we have a roll call on the table motion, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Goodman Hinderschitz, seconded by Councilor Reed to table Bill number 5-2021. Ms. Goodman Hinderschitz?
Yes.
Mr. Marmaru?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Ms. Ventura?
Yes.
Mr. Walton Preston?
Yes.
5 yeas, no nays.
All right, our next ordinance is Bill number 6-2021, amending the City Code Chapter 62, pensions by replacing administrative services references to finance department and by allowing the mayor to appoint a designee on the fire and O&E pension boards. This was introduced at the January 11th regular meeting. Is there a motion, please?
So moved.
Second.
Properly moved and seconded. Are there any comments or questions at this time? All right. If not, Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Marmaru, seconded by Councilor Ventura, to enact Bill number 6-2021, which amends the fire and officers and employees pension ordinance. Mr. Marmaru?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Ms. Ventura?
Yes.
Ms. Goodman Hinderschitz?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
5 yeas, no nays.
All right, the next ordinance is Bill number 7-2021, amending the property maintenance rules and regulations in the city's code of ordinances, chapter 180, part 12, as attached in exhibit A regarding solid waste. This was introduced at the January 11th regular meeting. Is there a motion, please?
So moved.
Second.
Been properly moved and seconded. Are there any comments at this time? If not, Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Goodman Hinderschitz, seconded by Councilor Ventura, to enact Bill number 7-2021, which makes amendments to the property maintenance rules regarding solid waste. Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Ms. Ventura?
Yes.
Ms. Goodman Hinderschitz?
Yes.
Mr. Marmaru?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
5 yeas, no nays.
All right, the next ordinance is Bill number 8-2021, amending the Solid Waste Ordinance, Chapter 496, Part 2, regarding collection from mixed-use properties. This was introduced at the January 11th regular meeting. Is there a motion, please?
So moved.
It's been properly moved and seconded. Are there any comments? And this ordinance just allows the administration some flexibility where they have a multi-unit building where there's also a business established. So just a brief recap. If there's no other comments, Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Reed, seconded by Councilor Marmaru to enact Bill number 8-2021, which amends the solid waste ordinance regarding collection for mixed use properties. Ms. Ventura?
Yeah.
Ms. Goodman Hinderschitz?
Yes.
Mr. Marmaru?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
5 yeas, no nays.
Okay, the final ordinance is Bill 9-2021, increasing the salary of the CD director to $110,000, contingent on the $20,000 contribution from the Reading Redevelopment Authority, retroactive back to the beginning of this year. This was introduced at the January 11th regular meeting. Is there a motion, please?
So moved.
Second.
It's been properly moved and seconded. Are there any comments?
I would like the administration to explain the funding procedure here.
All right, who's prepared to, we don't have Abe this evening. Is Jamar on the call?
Council President, I could answer that question if you like. The increases, the increase that's being introduced or being asked to be approved for the community development director will be covered by our intergovernmental agreement that we entered previously between the city and the redevelopment authority. These additional duties that are mentioned in this document are functionalities of executive director of the Reading Redevelopment Authority. So those are additional duties. Therefore, the best way to look at it is like the RA is contracting us out for these services. So they pay or reimburse the city for these services. And because these services are being provided by various personnel, including the community development director, that this will be reflective, the increase is reflective on the increased responsibilities. So the money's being provided by the Reading Redevelopment Authority through their funding source and not the city's general fund or any other source.
Okay, are there any additional questions at this time? Go ahead, Marcia.
Okay, and this is a question directed to Frank Dombowski. It was my understanding when we had discussion regarding this position in Committee of the Whole that there would be a job description that would include the increased responsibilities as relevant to the Redevelopment Authority?
Absolutely, and thank you for that information. That will be provided to City Council in the next day or two. The job description will be reflective of what we're asking. So that will be provided, yes.
Okay, are there any other questions or comments? Donna?
You're on mute, Donna.
Donna, you're muted.
One other, how does that figure, the funding then figure with pension? Does that all get pulled together even though the funding's from two separate things?
That's a very good question. Obviously, when somebody's base salary increases, their pension increases. Well, potentially, keep in mind, the employee's calculation increases also. So
that's not increasing his base salary, though. It's contingent.
The way that it is written, his base salary, I believe, is $92,500. Mm-hmm. And then the $20,000 is contingent on that $20,000 payment coming from the Redevelopment Authority. So his base salary has remained the same.
So there's no pension implications? Is that?
I would have to double check with the pension board.
Well, thank you both for that clarification. I was inaccurate in my answer. Thank you.
Okay, are there any other comments or questions, Marcia?
Yeah, and this is a comment. I think when you look at past practice, when the Redevelopment Authority was a separate entity, there was a full salary that was paid for the executive director that it was considerably higher than the amount of this increase. So if you take it into calculation, because that is public money going into an authority, that it actually, and it doesn't appear this way, because it looks like obviously you're raising a salary, but there actually might be some cost savings for the entire operation.
Okay, if there's no other comments or questions at this time, I'm gonna ask Linda to give us a roll call, please.
Motion was made by Councilor Reed, seconded by Councilor Grimmon-Hinderschitz to enact Bill Number 9, 2021, which increases the salary of the CD director contingent upon the $20,000 contribution from the Reading Redevelopment Authority. Ms. Grimmon-Hinderschitz.
Yes.
Mr. Marmaru.
Yes.
Ms. Reed.
Yes.
Ms. Ventura.
Yeah.
Mr. Waltman, President.
Yes.
Five yeas, no nays.
Okay, we're going to move on to the introduction of new ordinances. We have three this evening. I'm going to ask that Councilwoman Marcia Goodman-Hinderschitz please read them onto the record.
Sir. Okay, A, ordinance amending the city code section 576 to 603, daytime parking restrictions, notice of violations and penalties, waivers to modify the manner in which notice of a violation is provided and to change the threshold for the immobilization or removal of a vehicle. B, ordinance amending the city code section 576 to 517, parking meters, or kiosk, notice of violation, violations and penalties, waiver to modify the manner in which notice of a violation is provided. C, ordinance increasing the HR director's salary. Oh, wait a minute, I'm sorry, that is admitted. That has been withdrawn from the administration. I apologize. Okay, so it would be C, ordinance amending the 2021 position ordinance by reclassifying one position on the Human Resources Department from Human Resource Assistant to Training and Employment Coordinator.
Okay, thank you, Marcia. We're going to move on to resolutions. I'm going to do the first two together unless there's any objection. Those resolutions are both appointments. The first appointment is Ricky D'Annunzio to the Stadium Commission, and the second appointment is Mr. Gary Yeager Jr. to the Stadium Commission as well. Is there a motion for those two resolutions, please?
So moved.
Second.
It's been properly moved and seconded. Are there any comments?
Well, it's good to see Mr. D'Annunzio back on the board. He was on before and he had to step down for personal reasons, but he has been he was an asset, and I know he's going to be an asset again. And Mr. Yeager, wonderful person. I know he's going to be an asset to the Stadium Commission. Thank you.
Okay, any other comments? If not, Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Marmaru, seconded by Councilor Goodman-Hinderschitz to adopt resolutions 9 and 10, 2021, which makes appointments to the Stadium Commission. Mr. Marmaru?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Ms. Ventura?
Yeah.
Ms. Goodman-Hinderschitz?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
5 yeas, no nays.
Okay, the next resolution is relinquishing the public rights to the public walk shown on the topographical survey of the city of Reading between 1305 and 1307 East Wyomissing Boulevard, which connects Museum Road and Wyomissing Boulevard, are hereby relinquished as of the date hereof to the owners of the properties located at 1305 East Wyomissing Boulevard and 1307 East Wyomissing Boulevard in the city of Reading. Is there a motion, please?
So moved.
Second.
Okay. Okay, it's been properly moved and seconded. Are there any comments? All right, if there are no comments, then can we have a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Reed, seconded by Councilor Ventura, to adopt Resolution 11, 2021, which relinquishes the public rights to the walkway between 1305 and 1307 East Wyomissing Boulevard. Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Ms. Ventura?
Yeah.
Ms. Goodman-Hinderschitz?
Yes.
Mr. Marmaru?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
5 yeas, no nays.
Okay, the next resolution is ratifying the memorandum agreement. I'm going to take these two together. If there's no objection, they're the same, except there's two separate unions. Ratifying the memorandum agreement between the city and the ASME Local 3799 and ASME Local 2763 regarding salary changes as set forth in the agreement with an effective date of November 23rd and attached as Exhibit A. Somebody move these resolutions forward, please.
So moved.
Second.
Properly moved and seconded. Are there any comments? All right, if there are no comments, Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Reed, seconded by Councilor Marmaru, to adopt resolutions 12 and 13, 2021, which ratifies the AFSME 3799 and 2763 contracts making salary adjustments. Ms. Ventura?
Yeah.
Ms. Goodman-Hinderschitz?
Yes.
Mr. Marmaru?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
5 yeas, no nays.
Okay, I believe that brings us up to our final order of business. That would be council comments. Does anybody have anything pressing they need to share this evening?
I do.
Go ahead, Strad.
Okay. Today I was listening on the radio, and one of our local radio stations which allows people to go on and make comments concerning anything they want to. I heard an individual, singly not a member of this administration, as a moron. I don't think we should allow things like this to take place. This man that was making the comments lives in Lehigh County and has all kinds of complaints and gets on the radio and he calls one of our officials a moron. He has five rental properties here in the city and they're all leased out. They're not paying their bills and he's upset because he has to pay the bills of the renters who are not paying, so he's taking it out on us. He's complaining about one of the renters leaving his trash cans out front and getting cited. Because he's not getting cited, the owner is. He's getting cited. I told them they should get a hold of this man and have him call into the city hall when he has a complaint instead of just calling in and making complaints like this. Another thing I like to request is, with these shots that we are supposed to be taking, people like yourselves that are still working, has anybody got any information when this is going to take place for the employees of our police and firemen and you people that are still working in City Hall and guys like me that are 88 years old that are supposed to be taken care of? Does anybody know? We are the ones that are supposed to be taken care of now. And wasn't there somebody designated or directed in at City Hall that was going to handle this? Does anybody know? Thank you.
Okay, I think some information was shared on that.
Abe shared that information with us at their last council meeting. I believe he said mid-February as we go through the ranks. Then the prior comment was Strat. You know, we're all public figures. That's free speech. Unless we're being threatened or something, we put ourselves in that situation. It's unfortunate.
Yes. Did you say that was taken care of at the last meeting?
Well, Abe spoke to it.
Yeah. I'm going to ask Marcia or Donna if you're aware of any resources for Strat to get a shot, or Linda, let's try to channel some of that information to him. It's starting to seep down now, Strat, so hopefully soon you'll have access to a shot. Hopefully we
Thank
all
you.
Will. Yeah, hopefully we all will, but all right. Any other comments?
Yes, Council President, and this is actually very much tied into Council Marmaru's comment, even though not specifically answering his question. I just wanted to inform the public and my colleagues that for my upcoming MAC show, I have a representative coming from the Berks Community Health Center. We're going to speak on a range of COVID-19 issues. And even though the topic's in your district, I feel this impacts not only my constituents in District 2, but everyone, that we need to get as much up-to-date information as possible. The reality is there is not an adequate supply of vaccines for us to be vaccinated as quickly as we might like to be. We're going to be discussing that. And so that what I'll do is once the show's recorded on MAC, I will be providing a link to the City Council Facebook page so that people can access it. But there's a lot of good information, including how to address people's anxiety regarding the COVID-19 vaccine and how we have to understand how we need to move together with continued safety precautions. So I'm very excited to have those individuals joining me. I would welcome anyone from the administration. I did send a link out to the mayor and our communications director. So again, if you want to join tomorrow, the show is going to be recorded at 1 o'clock on the MAC channel. And then moving ahead. And I attempted to demonstrate, but I will be also helping to promote vaccines by wearing a face mask that says vaccines save lives. I know the city council staff have those and have been wearing them. So we need to be able to, just as we're concerned about other public health issues, this is just vital for us moving ahead. So I'm hoping, Councilman Marmaru, that the city can give us information. You should be on the top of the list for getting a vaccine. Okay, so hopefully that can happen. I know I've run into personal challenges about just getting something very quickly. It's going to take a while, but you know, hopefully you can be at the front of the line, Strat. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Hello.
This is Nate. If I may, Strat, if you call your primary care doctor, they'll get you right in. I called in for my grandmother and they got her right in for the shot.
We'll see. Thank you.
Okay, guys. Any other comments this evening, council members? Okay. If not, real quickly, our meeting schedule is as follows. We have, oh boy, we have a regular meeting. Is that correct? That's not correct. Monday, February 1st?
No.
Our meeting schedule's a little out of whack here. Linda, real quickly, will you announce our meetings for the next 2 weeks?
Yeah, the 8th.
No, Linda.
We have a nominations and committee of the whole meeting on February 1st, starting at 4. And yes. Then we have a committee of the whole and a regular meeting on Monday, February 8th, like starting at 5.
Yeah, I see what happened. I couldn't understand that. Okay, great. All right. If there's no other, no other business at this time, we just simply need a motion to adjourn.
You got it.
All right. Thank you, everyone, and have a great evening. Be safe.
Thank you.